Thank you for coming.
Susan, I'm so sorry. My deepest condolences.
Yes, thank you.
Marcus.
Yes, Marcus, thank you for coming.
We'll all miss him terribly.
Yes, it's a great loss.
We'll all miss him.
Yes.
You must feel terrible.
Well, I don't feel good. It was a terrible shock.
Death is always a shock. You're sitting home doing nothing, and then death goes boo. Somebody falls down dead.
Yes.
What were his last words? Were they boo?
What, boo? No, he didn't have any last words.
Did he make any last noises?
Noises? What?
Guttural sorts of noises, or high-pitched shrieking ones.
Just noises. They were lower than that. Don't do that anymore.
Oh, Susan, you poor, poor thing. I wouldn't wait if I were you. I'm going to be a while. All alone in that house now. Alone in the kitchen. Alone in the dining room. Alone in the living room. Living room. Oh, that's a mocking phrase now, isn't it? Alone, 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 all alone, 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 alone.
Please don't go on.
Susan, you have to mourn, Susan, to mourn. I always thought the Irish had it right to do all that keening. Would you like to keen, Susan?
I don't think so, but thank you anyway.
How about singing a Negro spiritual?
Oh, I don't think so.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Thank you for coming.
Don't you want to sing?
No, I don't want to sing or keen. I'm an Episcopalian. I'll cry quietly in my room tonight by myself. Now, I must attend to the other mourners.
Susan, you are avoiding your sadness. I can't let you do that.
Please, please let me do that. I'm having a terrible day. I have to bury my husband.
Is he in the casket? It's a closed casket. He's not in another room, propped up in a stuffed chair or other, waiting to startle somebody, is he?
Certainly not. Thank you for coming.
That would give somebody quite a fright, standing there by this chair, making conversation, and then they realize they're talking to him, but he's stark stone dead. That would be a good one.
Yes. Oh, David!
You know, I'm going to miss your husband.
Oh, how interesting.
You're not the only one with sorrow on your forehead.
What?
I should say not. Magic marker doesn't wash off. We're going to miss him on the commuter train. We used to exchange morning pleasantries. Nice morning. Cold enough for you? The train seems to be running on time for a change.
I see. Excuse me, I think the mortician is signaling me, so...
Your husband was the only one on that whole damn train that was willing to speak to me.
How interesting.
All the other people, they could panic in their eyes if I even start walking in their direction. Then they move away, or they pretend to be sleeping, but they don't fool me. I'm no dope. You can't sleep standing up.
Well, maybe if you're tired enough, maybe you can.
Your husband, though, he was always very friendly. Not like my father. Nowadays, he won't even return my phone calls. I went to a seance and everything.
What?
Well, he's dead. I have this medium friend who gave me this special 800 number that lets you call the dead. Maybe you'd like the number to reach your husband on the other side.
I don't think so. Well, que sera sera. Ami la di da. Thank you so much for coming.
Well, you're welcome. I just feel really terrible about your husband. I don't know what I'm going to do on the train in the morning.
Well, why don't you read a book?
That's an idea. Do you have any suggestions?
I don't know. 50 Shades of Grey, Great Expectations, any book, I don't care.
My favorite book is Babar the Elephant.
Yes, that's excellent.
Have you read it?
No, but I've heard wonderful things. Well, thank you so much for coming. Goodbye.
Are you leaving?
No, I'm not leaving. I want you to leave. You're making me hysterical. Can't you take a hint when I say, thank you for coming? That's code for go away now. Don't you understand that?
Oh, well, I thought it just meant thank you for coming. I didn't realize I... Wait, is there anything else you've said in code that I haven't understood?
No, I don't know. I don't think so.
Oh, good.
It's just that... Oh. Now I feel guilty having expressed my feelings.
No, you shouldn't feel guilty about expressing your feelings. That's a good thing to do. You've had a terrible loss.
Yes, I have.
Are you sure you don't want a keen yet? I'm not Irish, but it seems like a very appropriate thing to do at a funeral.
I don't know, maybe later.
Well, this would be the most likely time.
I don't know. What does keening sound like?
Oh, it's really interesting. It's sort of like this.
Please stop staring. Go back to your conversational buzz.
Did I do something wrong again?
Well, it's a very startling sound.
Well, it's just like crying, but more dramatic. I love to cry. You loved your husband, didn't you?
Yes.
Well, then, don't you want to keen a little?
Well, I understand a little, but I don't really think I could.
You could do it softer than I did.
I don't know.
Come on, please. I know it'll make you feel better.
Would it? This is hard to do in public. Maybe I could call you later tonight and do it over the phone.
No. It's more healing to do it at the funeral. You shouldn't do it on the phone.
Oh, I don't know.
Come on. It will help. That's good.
Ooh.
That's good.
Ooh.
That's good. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ha 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 ha! better?
Oh, thank you for coming. No, it's not cold. I feel much better.
Oh, good. You're welcome.